Hello friends, welcome to Ramya's Delicusins. இன்றைக்கி நம்ம இந்த வீடியோவில் என்ன பார்க்க போகிறோம்னா, வாட் இஸ் ரெசியூமே, கரிக்குலம் விட்டே அண்ட் பயோடேட்டா, அந்த மூணுக்கும் உள்ள டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் என்ன, அது எங்கேருந்து ஆரிஜினேட் ஆனது அப்படின்றத பார்க்க போகிறோம். அதோட இப்போ இருக்கிற நிறைய ஜாப் சீக்கர்ஸ்க்கு ஹவு டு ரைட் ரெசியூமேன்றது வந்து இட்ஸ் டிஃபிகல்ட் டு ஃபைண்ட் அவுட். ஸோ அதை பற்றின ஒரு கிளாரிஃபிகேஷன் வேணும் அப்படிங்கிறதுக்காக தான் இந்த வீடியோ ரெடி பண்ணியிருக்கிறோம். வாங்க வீடியோக்குள்ளே போகலாம், அதை பற்றி தெரிஞ்சுக்கலாம். தெரிஞ்சுக்கிட்டு நமக்கு தெரிஞ்சதை மற்றவங்களுக்கும் சொல்லி கொடுக்கலாம்.
ஐ வெல்கம் யூ ஆல் டு தி ரம்யாஸ் டெலிகேஷன்ஸ் சேனல். அண்ட் டுடே வி ஆர் டிஸ்கஸிங் அபவுட் how to write a resume or curriculum vitae or bio data. So these three terms are almost one and the same. Whenever the candidates applying for a job, he or she is in a position to write a resume or curriculum vitae or bio data to the employer, where he seeks for his or her job. Now, among the three terms, resume, curriculum vitae, and bio data, for this one, resume is originated from American English, resume, American English, which means summary of a person for the job, for getting the job. Another term, curriculum vitae, which is shortly known as CV, curriculum vitae. This word originated from British English, Britain. This again, a written record of a candidate seeking the job. And then biodata. The word is Indianism. The word originated from India. Once upon a time, the candidates, they used biodata. And when the time, passes away, these two came into the field, resume, curriculum vitae. But you see, resume gained its value currency, whereas CV, curriculum vitae, not became very popular. But the word resume became very popular. Why? The candidates should remember the facts behind this. You see, this resume, since it is originated from America, the students working in, or the candidates working in software, they use resume writing very frequently. They used the term very frequently. As a result, the word became very famous, popular. Because of the IT people, most of the people working in America, they popularized the term resume. And the advertisement very frequently comes like this: send your resume along with your application. Remember this statement very carefully. Send your resume along with your application. So they demand two items, not only your summary that you furnish in the resume, but send your application also. Why this? We can easily write, candidates can easily write resume, but writing an application is somewhat difficult, they feel. And that's why purposely they avoid or attach an application along with the resume. And the employer received the letter from the candidate and he opens it. Only resume form is there, format is there, but there is missing of writing on application. So in that case, employer simply dismisses the resume of the candidate not sending the application along with the resume. Why? In resume, you see, you give your personal details, educational qualifications, and other items, your experience, personal skills, your professional skills, what will you do if you are selected for the job, what is your contribution to the organization. So these details you have to furnish in the resume. So in the resume you write your name, Mr. Gajendran, name, nationality, Indian, date of birth, so and so, marital status, married or not married. You see, writing this kind of details becomes so easy for anybody. Writing your name, writing your date of birth, writing your nationality. No skill is necessary for this. Even a layman can write all these things. But what about your education? Why you hesitate writing your application? Saying everything about you, about your personal details, qualifications, and giving some other requirements. And why the employer demands this application particularly? Why? Because there he can find your English, your expression, your communication in writing. That becomes difficult to the candidate. he is not able to write a sentence or sentences with some mistakes, the employer immediately find them out, their errors. He comes to the conclusion that this candidate is very weak in communication, writing communication, not suitable for the job. When he is working in the firm or company, he will not be able to write a communique, that is communication letter. So he simply dismisses his application. And he selected otherwise, that is application along with the resume, and application without mistakes, glaring mistakes, somewhat acceptable, maybe one or two mistakes, or without mistakes. Now the employer send a card to the candidate that you have been tentatively selected for the job in our company or in our firm. So this is how the employer chooses the candidate. So your communication, writing communication, is very important, not your resume. There is no grammar at all, there is no structural pattern in resume. Just putting your name, date of birth, your qualification, nationality, that's all. For which no writing of sentences. But when it comes to the point of an application writing, you have to write in full sentences where to put punctuation marks like full stop, semicolon, dash, hyphen, everything. The employer will note down everything you failed. As a result, the employer will not choose you for the job. This is one fact with regard to resume writing. It gains its popularity because of the IT people. Since the software originated from America, all the software people they use American English instead of British English. We accept only British English in writing. That is the accepted language internationally. But after the inception of this software in America, IT people concentrated on, or they encouraged, American English, because in the system they find American spelling. For example, color, American spelling COLOR, but in British English COLOUR. For another word, program, PROGRAMME, British English, PROGRAME, American English. And these words find place in the software, the computer. And as a result, American English getting its popularity because of these people, IT people. And no advertisement we find now. Send your CV, send your curriculum vitae along with application. No advertisement. We don't see, this kind of advertisement. Send your CV. Once it was there, but now they totally abandoned. Employer totally abandoned. The word resume gained its currency. It has got its value, but not a curriculum vitae. then what about biodata? It is out of date now, because the word originated from India. The word is Indianism. Nobody asks in their, in one's advertisement, send your biodata along with application. No such advertisement nowadays. And you see, the pronunciation for the word R-E-S-U-M-E, this is noun, summary of a person. How to pronounce this? Resume, resume. And another word is there, verb. Part of speech is verb. Resume, resume, which means he resumed his work. You see, this is verb. He resumed his work. Avan velaikku thirumbi vittan. He resumed, verb. Resume, personal record, noun, part of speech. அது வந்து நவுனா ஆக்ட் பண்ணது ரெசியூமே. ஆனால் ரெசியூம் அப்படிங்கிறது ஹி ரெசியூம்டு ஹிஸ் ஜாப், ஹி ரெசியூம்டு ஹிஸ் ஒர்க், ஹி கோஸ் பேக் டு ஹிஸ் ஒர்க். திரும்பி அவர் வேலையில் ஜாயின் பண்ணிட்டான், ஒர்க்குக்கு போயிட்டான். ஆக ரெசியூம், R-E-S-U-M-E-ங்கிறது உச்சரிப்பு ஒன்று ரெசியூமே, அதான் பர்சனல் டீடைல்ஸ். இன்னொன்று ரெசியூம், அது வந்து ஒர்க்குக்கு திரும்பி போகிறது, ஆனால் அது வந்து வெறுப்பு. கரிக்குலம் விட்டைக்கு வந்து இந்த மாதிரி டீட்டெயில்ஸ் வந்து எதுவுமே தேவையில்லை. சரி, இப்போ எம்ப்ளாயர் வந்து என்னென்ன எதிர்பார்ப்பாங்க ஒரு ரெசியூமேல? வாட் ஆர் யூ, நீ யார், டெல் அபவுட் யுவர் செல்ஃப், வாட் ஆர் யூ. அப்போ என்ன எக்ஸ்பெக்ட் பண்ணுறான்னா, ரெசியூமே கண்டென்ட்டில் என்ன எக்ஸ்பெக்ட் பண்ணுறான்னா, your personal details, that's the experience, educational qualification, your personal skills, adha what are you, what are you na adha what are you, what have you done so far, நீ ஏற்கனவே ஒரு கம்பெனியில் ஒர்க் பண்ணலையா, what have you done so far, இது வரைக்கும் அந்த கம்பெனி நீங்க என்ன பண்ணீங்க, what was your improvement இந்த ப்ரீவியஸ் கம்பெனி. அதாவது இதில் என்னென்னா, யுவர் பாஸ்ட் ப்ரொஃபஷனல் அக்காம்ப்ளிஷ்மெண்ட், உன்னுடைய அக்காம்ப்ளிஷ்மெண்ட், ப்ரொஃபஷனலாக நீ இது வரைக்கும் இதுக்கு முன்னாடி உள்ள கம்பெனியில் நான் இதை சாதிச்சிருக்கிறேன், ரிசல்ட்ஸ் இவ்வளவு ப்ரொடியூஸ் பண்ணியிருக்கிறேன், டார்கெட் இவ்வளவு அச்சீவ் பண்ணியிருக்கிறேன் அப்படின்னு சொல்கிறதுலாம், வாட் ஹேவ் யூ டன் ஸோ ஃபார், அந்த டீட்டெயில்ஸ் அங்கே கொடுக்கணும். அண்ட் தென் what can you do for us, suppose you are selected, what can you do for us, it is quite justifiable, the employer will expect such a thing from the candidate, what will you do for us, suppose you are selected, நீ உன்னை செலக்ட் பண்ணியாச்சு எங்க கம்பெனிக்கு வந்து நீ என்ன செய்வே, what will be your contribution, in what way you work, in what way you increase or equip yourselves professionally strong, professional ah romba strong ah vela paakradhukku vande nee eppadi ella pannuve, tell us those things, adhu kekkom, what are your further plans, adhu sonna piragu seri இந்த மாதிரி செய்வேன்ட்டு நீ சொல்லிட்ட, then what are your further plans to take the organization to the high level, sky level, அதுக்கு பிறகு வந்து நீ என்ன இம்ப்ரூவ்மெண்ட் கொண்டு வருவே, so அங்க எல்லாம் your future development, உன்னுடைய ரிசர்ச் எப்படி இருக்கும், டெவலப்மெண்ட் எப்படி இருக்கும், future development of your organization, so in that way what will be your contribution, so all these things they require or the employer expect from the candidates applying for the job. Yena, neki job ku vandu apply pandrathu vandu romba romba mukkiyam. Resume writing application vandu writing skill. Idhu vandu writing skill. Adhaadu communication skill vandu rendu idhula apply aagum. Onnu speaking skill, innonnu writing skill. Speaking level de your speed in communicating things, your feelings, emotions, etc. etc. Apo fluency vandu enga venumna speaking la definite this point is very important. So now you can understand what is resume writing, what is curriculum vitae, even though the term already lost its value, but anyhow we must know all these things. So resume writing, CV, biodata almost out of date. Okay, thank you very much for listening my class very well. Good.
இந்த வீடியோ உங்களுக்கு பிடிச்சிருந்தா லைக் பண்ணுங்க, கமெண்ட் பண்ணுங்க, ஷேர் பண்ணுங்க, மறக்காம சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பண்ணுங்க, அப்படியே அந்த பெல் பட்டனையும் கிளிக் பண்ணுங்க.